human actions on other life forms. What life forms are impacted by human actions and how?
Animals lose their habitat in the wild, some shrink in size and a lot are facing extinction such as tigers and turtles. Whilst plants may be killed by herbicides, overexposure to UV rays and soil at certain areas become too infertile.
When did the impacts first take place?
In the beginning of industrialization.
So, industrialization actually began in the 1780s during the British Industrial Revolution, which had been developing for several decades, and began to further accelerate. So, this actually caused manufacturing businesses and the number of wage laborers to skyrocket, thus causing trends to start during the first half of the 19th century.
Who should ensure the impacts don't get worse?
The government.
So even when I say the government, in general, people should help and play their part. But the government is actually the main role because they can make laws and rules stop people from doing all kinds of activities that may cause the pollution to be even further than it already is.
Where do these human activities commonly occur?
Everywhere, such as households, factories, eateries like restaurants and many more.
For example, I'm at the latest lake site now, and as you can see, there's like a lot of restaurants in the background, administration centers. Like, you may think they don't cause a lot of harm, but you know, the amount of papers they print every day and amount of trees being cut down. So you can say that, yes, a lot of places in general cause pollution.
Why do these human activities occur?
For example, at the fashion industry, they need to produce textiles. At the automobile industry, they need to produce cars and such. For the construction industry, they need to make materials from scratch such as bricks or wood panels, and even the mining industry where they exploit minerals from mining areas.
There's actually a vast reasons of why these human activities occur. Mainly because of progression, and what was mentioned just now was mostly examples of why it occurs, like the textiles and so on. But there are actually a lot more that we may not realize. The ones that we do know is typically like water sewages and so on. But, you know, they need to treat water, and like, what happens to all the fecal matter that you dump every day? Who knows, right? But actually, they, most often than not, even after being treated, they will still end up in clean waters, believe it or not.
How can we play our part in reducing the effects of human activities on their other life forms?
We could practice the 3R concept, which is to reduce, reuse and recycle. We are encouraged to use public transport when possible. Also, we must use water wisely and switch off the taps when not in use. Consumers should buy biodegradable products to reduce waste. Don't ever throw chemicals unnecessarily into rivers or whatnot, as it affects our drinking water too. These are some of the ways we can play our part to be more environmental friendly.
For students, what you can do is, every time you have a project to do, I suggest you can recycle materials, or if you have seniors that have just finished their brick project, get back like some of their materials. So these are just some of the ways. There's actually a lot more that you can play your part in. So I made a habit to like off the lights anywhere I go, maybe switch off the tap, or like if you take a shower and you're not actually using the water, switch it off. I know some people tend to not switch it off, which I think is a terrible habit, but it helps a lot because the water you waste is cheap, precious. As citizens of Earth, we should play our part into making sure that all these resources don't go to waste.